again, good morning. My name's Rebecca and I'm from Woodbine Wools. Woodbine Wools is a small family-run business that sells ethical yarns. That's usually meant by the question, what's that? So ethical yarns means that all of the wool and linen and silk and alpaca that we sell on our store is fair traded. We're a small family-run business and we sell ethically traded yarns, which means they're fair traded, they're organic, or they're ethically traded and on their way to fair trading. However, I'm not actually going to talk for 3.5 minutes now about yarn. I'm going to ask you to think about what you're wearing. And no, I'm not going to do fashion critique. I just want you to think about the fact that Britain is in the grip of throwaway fashion. Each year, an average of 2 million tonnes of clothing is bought in the UK. And each year, an average of 1 million tonnes of used clothing is thrown away, usually to landfill. The average person in the UK spends £650 a year on 50 or so items of clothing. And if you're sitting there thinking, well, I don't buy anything like that, imagine how much some people are buying. And the average person in the UK each year throws 30 kilos of clothing into landfill. Did you know it takes 10 times more energy to produce a tonne of textiles than a tonne of glass or a tonne of steel? Most used textiles end up in landfill and there they cause particular problems. Textiles that are synthetic or man-made do not decompose. And while textiles that are natural, such as cotton and wool, do decompose, they give off, as they decompose, they give off methane, which is 23 times more powerful than carbon dioxide at heating up the atmosphere. So, is there an answer to this other than wearing clothes made of steel or glass? Well, scientists have come up with the idea that if you didn't buy a single item of clothing, not one thing, for a whole year, you would save 72 kilos of carbon dioxide. However, I think most people would say that's not really a very practical suggestion. If we give it a bit of thought, we can make a real difference and we don't have to give up our sense of style. For example, if everyone in the UK bought just one item of reclaimed yarn, one jumper, one jacket of reclaimed yarn, it would save an average of 371 million gallons of water, and that's slightly more than one of our reservoirs in the UK would hold, and that's just for one item. You shouldn't discount the idea of buying second-hand clothing. I know it gets a bad press in some areas, but it is being repackaged and the fashion industry now calls this vintage clothing. And it really is up and coming to get vintage clothing. By buying and selling vintage clothing, we are cutting down dramatically on the amount of textiles going into landfill. The life of your current wardrobe instead of buying something new. Just because you bought something a few times, don't throw it away. Look at restyling it. Look at exchanging the collar or the cuffs that are on the garment at the moment for something you've knitted or crocheted for yourself. Why not change the buttons? Add a belt. Remove a belt. It's very easy to extend and change the look of a whole garment. most of all, make more. Most of all, make the move from fast fashion to slow fashion. Rediscover, or for those of you younger, learn from yourself from the start, that fewer clothes of better quality will actually last you longer. Yes, you can get a cardigan off the shelf from a cheap shop for £10 or less. But it will be mass produced. Often there'll be very little care taken over the materials used, over the workers, over the environment, and even over the garments itself. So that once you've worn it half a dozen times, it's going to start sagging, it's going to start looking baggy, it'll bobble, it'll look dreadful, you'll find it in the bin, and it will end up in landfill. That cardigan will also be exactly the same as the cardigan being worn by hundreds of other men or women around the country. So, the alternative is to buy for yourself needles or hooks and yarn, and spend time with friends, talking, laughing, creating, learning, sharing, making your own unique handcrafted garment, which will last you for years. I was talking to somebody earlier on, Chris over there at one of the stands, and saying that my dad's still wearing a sweater I knitted for him when I was at university. I did not say it on film, but that's over 25 years ago. On the note of making and creating for yourself, can I remind you that Woodbine Wools will be giving you the opportunity to indulge your hooks and needles at 1 o'clock over there in the, I think it's called the open room. If any of you are sitting there thinking, I wish I'd brought my project along now, I will have some spare yarn and needles that you can borrow. And if any of you are sitting there thinking, I don't actually knit, add the word yet onto the end and come down and see me. And can I